I'm a pug owner and lover, so this next organization is very, very near and dear to my heart. I'm here with Angelina and Erica from PugHearts Houston Pug Rescue, and they're here today to tell us about their wonderful organization and a wonderful event that's actually coming up later this month. So, well, first off, welcome to the show.
Thank you.
And tell us who we have here today.
This is Iggy. He is 10 months old.
And this is Violet, about 5 years old.
And this is my boy, Cooper. He doesn't need to be rescued. He's already been rescued. So tell us a little bit about PugHearts, exactly what you all do.
So we are a foster-based rescue, a nonprofit. We rescue pugs from all over Texas, the southern states, Louisiana, Alabama, Mississippi. Our motto is we take any pug in any condition, at any age, anytime. Mm-hmm. We take any pug, period, regardless of the health. And we try to find them perfect forever homes.
Yeah, and when speaking of finding them homes, on your website, you can scroll through and see their bios and their pictures and whatnot. But I think a big misconception that people have is you get on the website and you can just, you know, pick one out and whatnot. But there's actually an extensive application process, correct?
There is. You have to fill it out completely. And then with that, we do a vet check. And what we're checking for is consistency of past vaccinations, heartworm prevention, spaying and neutering of the animals in your home. We speak with personal references, and then we also physically do a home check.
Got it. And also, this isn't, like you said, this is a foster base, so there's no actual place for people to go and see the dogs, correct?
That's correct. We have about 90 foster homes all throughout Houston, and all of our dogs are in individual homes with families.
Got it. And talk to me a little bit about pugs. I know people think, you know, they look really cute and whatnot, but they do have a number of health problems that people need to be aware of, correct?
They do. Pugs are indoor-only dogs. They have the brachiocephalus with the flat. They can't cool themselves down, so they have to stay inside. They can get heat stroke very, very easily. Mm-hmm. Also, they are susceptible to the cold as well.
Yeah.
They shed. They snort.
Yes. Yes.
They have gas. I mean, that's just one of the things that you have to deal with when you have a pug. You'll never go outside without pug fur again
once you
have one.
That is totally true. So tell us a little bit about this event that's coming up later this month called Pugs on the Bayou, and it's a big event that y'all have every year, correct?
That's right. Pugs on the Bayou. It's at the Bayou Event Center. It is on October 19th. This is our annual fundraiser. We have a DJ. Food, a ticket includes dinner, dessert, we have a cash bar, shopping, a big pug pen. We also have about 5 banquet table lengths of auction items, anywhere from vacations, jewelry, Astros items, mm-hmm. Texans items. And if you can't make it, there's an app called Handbid that you can download. Look for Pugs on the Bayou, and you can bid through
the
app.
Okay. And this event, like I said, is not only for pugs. If you have other dogs, other dogs are welcome, correct?
Every dog is welcome.
Okay.
Every dog is welcome, and every single penny that this event makes goes directly to our vet bills. And last year, our vet bill was almost $400,000. And
wow.
We do everything we possibly can for these dogs. We don't skimp out on any of the vet care. So donations are very, mm-hmm. very welcomed, and fosters, volunteers, and we would love to see you at Pugs on the Bayou.
And where can people go to find out more information about this?
Go to our website at www.pughearts.com. You can buy a ticket for adults. It's $40, and that does include dinner, dessert, a drink. We do have a cash bar for those wanting alcohol. And kids 13 and under is 10. And you can buy tickets online. You can buy tickets at the door for an additional, it's a little bit more if you purchase at the door.